Revelia.
Can't afford to coddle students when it comes to defense.
I wish they'd let Roman teach the entire curriculum.
Professor Sharp terrifies me. He glanced sideways at me last week and I thought he was entirely wrong. Welcome back.
Hello, Professor. I have news. The goblins are looking for something. Another repository. They've built drills to help with their search.
Most troubling.
Are these repositories like the broken container I found at Rookwood Castle?
They are. I fear we have no time to lose. Have a look at the map.
Fortunately, the next trial is fairly nearby.
It's Hogwarts.
As you know, I was headmistress in my time. My portrait hangs in the headmaster's office. In fact, I witnessed Professor Black learn of your arrival. And I'll confess that I wondered about you.
Wait, is the next trial in the headmaster's office?
It is. I had hoped that when the time came, the occupant of that office would be of help to us. Unfortunately, this headmaster seems wildly unconcerned with anything but himself. You'll need to access the office while he's away.
I understand. Very well. We'll find some way to get in.
Good. I shall meet you in my portrait there. Until then.
Access to the headmaster's office. Perhaps Professor Fig will know what to do.
Now what am I supposed to do?
Lumos.
Professor
Professor Fig, the keepers have shown me where the next trial is.
Has something changed?
Lodgok and I have learned that the goblins are searching for another repository, like the one we saw at Rookwood Castle. And I discovered that they're building massive drills to help in their search. Professor Fitzgerald seemed very concerned.
I see. Ranrock clearly knows even more than we suspected.
And, sir, there's something else. Lodgok knew Miriam.
He knew Miriam?
They encountered each other at Rookwood Castle. She was doing research. That's where she found the container with the portkey. He liked her so much that he let her leave with it, despite orders from Ranrock.
I don't know what to say. She could win over almost anyone. I want to hear more of this. And, in fact, I'd like to speak with Lodgok directly. But we've no time now. Where is the next trial?
Believe it or not, it's in the headmaster's office.
Incredible. Very well, you'll need the password to get past the stone gargoyle. The headmaster's house elf will know it.
I don't know the headmaster's house elf. Will he even speak to me? I imagine he's loyal to the headmaster.
He is. So you'll need a disguise. I have just the thing, a polyjuice potion. You'll look and sound like Professor Black.
Wait, doesn't polyjuice potion require a bit of the person you want to change into? And take ages to brew?
It does.
So how do you already have polyjuice potion to change into Professor Black?
One never knows when such a thing may come in handy. Let's just say I felt the need to be prepared for anything after my fruitless trip to the Ministry on his behalf. Now, time is of the essence. Drink up and I shall explain more. How do you feel?
Incredible. I won't forget that taste anytime soon. How do I sound?
Convincing. I've taken the liberty of transfiguring your robes. As we discussed, you'll need the password from Scrope, who could be anywhere in the castle. You might look for Professor Kagawa. She's taken to badgering the poor elf about Quidditch in the hopes that he can convince Black to change his mind. Thus far, unsuccessfully.
I see. But what if Professor Black sees me?
Leave him to me. I shall tell him where to meet a liaison from the Ministry in Hogsmeade. That should give you plenty of time.
Thank you, Professor. I suppose we'll meet again in the map chamber.
It's rather strange to hear gratitude coming from Professor Black. I'll see you there.
Now to find the headmaster's house elf.
Professor, a moment of your time, please. Professor, I was hoping to catch you.
Places to be, Professor Sharp. Places to be.
Of course, sir. Only, you'd asked me about a particular potion, and I
did? I did, yes. Well, spit it out, Sharp. I don't have all day.
Probably best not to discuss it here, sir.
I assure you, Sharp, you may speak freely.
Very well. I've brewed the cure for boils you wanted. I can drop it by your office when it's convenient.
Of course, yes. No need for all the cloak and dagger. Simply have a student deliver it.
A student. Very well, sir, if you insist.
I do. And thank you, Sharp. I just hope you've brewed enough for all my boils.
Now, to determine which student gets this rather unenviable task.
Greetings! I mean, out of my way, children! If you must speak with me, consult my secretaries or what have you. Now move along.
What could the headmaster want?
Gareth! Mr. Weasley! What are you doing here? Don't you have somewhere to be?
Oh, Professor! Yes, of course!
All sorts of places I'd rather be right now.
Do you need something from me?
I'm looking for my house elf. Surely you've seen him?
Ah, the little one-eared fellow. I saw him heading to the Great Hall moments ago. Muttering on about your, sterling graces, sir.
I am watching you, Mr. Weasley. Mr. Redding, who owns Honeydukes, tells me some of his billywig stings recently went missing. Prime potion ingredient. And I know you fancy yourself a skilled potioneer.
What? But, sir, I haven't been anywhere near Honeydukes.
Bah! That's enough from you. Just know that I have eyes and ears everywhere. On your way, Mr. Weasley.
Well, there's one for my diary.
Chewing with your mouth open? Where are your manners?
Headmaster, here. What could he want?
Mr. Gaunt! Where do you think you're going?
I beg your pardon, sir. I'm simply on my way outside.
Taking the day off, eh? Typical student, wasting the hours away.
I have to write 20 inches on Dittany and its uses. Was heading to the greenhouse.
Ah, yes! Mixed with, bubo tuba pus makes a fine, mustache paste. Yes, mustache paste. I find.
Are you feeling all right, sir? You don't seem yourself.
I assure you, I am quite healthy, Gaunt. If I need a medical diagnosis, I shall head to St. Mungo's.
Something.
I haven't time for any of you at the moment. None. None at all. Move aside.
Professor, a word?
I should like to speak with you, Professor.
Professor Black, again, it is not too late to reconsider your decision regarding Quidditch. We could still have trials and a somewhat shortened season. It would be better than none at all.
But the injury, Madam Kogawa.
Professor, more than one student has taken a bludger to the head on our pitch. I dare say it knocked some sense into them. And they are fine now. The fact that it happened to be a pureblood, well, that's no reason to...
What nonsense! That you would trivialize the health of a student over a silly game.
A silly game? You are quite impossible sometimes. Sir, I've a good mind to write to the Department of Magical Games and Sports at the Ministry about you.
Good idea. I can even provide the parchment should you need it. Now... Where is my elf?
Parchment? Very well, I will, and with pleasure. And I spotted Scrope in the Great Hall. Seems to be avoiding me.
I wonder why. Good day, Madam Kogawa.
What did we do to deserve him as a headmaster?
I'd hate transfiguration.
Stand proud, purebloods. The future is yours.
Anything I've been doing.
Miss Broom, a word.
Oh, Professor, this is an interesting surprise. It's Bloom, by the way.
Remind me of your area of affinity, Broom. OWLs are swift approaching.
Charms, sir. Non-verbal spells. Might work on one that makes me disappear.
Well, keep at it, Broom. And before you know it, you'll be as invisible as that new fifth year seems to be.
They're not invisible, sir. I've seen them near the library. In fact, they help me with my, heavy books.
Speaking of invisible, where's my blasted house elf?
Something seems a little off with the headmaster.
I wonder almost daily why I accepted this appointment from the Ministry.
Professor, a word, please. Hello, Professor Black.
Ah, Professor Weasley. How delightful to see you.
Sir?
Since I have you here, I wonder if I might, speak with you about Professor Fig.
Oh, very well.
I've decided to give him a bit more, leeway with his time.
Leeway, Professor? Are you sure that's wise? I confess I do worry for his students. He's rarely here as it is.
Ah, well, yes. He's handling some official ministry business for me.
I see. But, sir, if I may, I am wary of how much time the new fifth year seems to be spending away from the castle, supposedly on Professor Fig's behalf. I've heard unsettling rumors of their escapades. Everything from sneaking into the Forbidden Forest to confronting Ranrock's loyalists and Rookwood's lot.
What? Goodness. You cannot believe everything you hear, Professor. No, you cannot. I mean, I shall keep an eye on Fig. You simply keep doing the wonderful job that you're doing. Simply wonderful.
Thank you. But I'm happy to look into...
Good. That'll be all, Weasley. I mean, Professor Weasley. Good day.
A wonderful job. Leeway for Professor Fig. I shall never understand that man.
That ought to give Professor Fig some breathing room.
Scrope's as hard a worker as any house elf.
Scrope!
Oh, greetings, Master.
Remind me of the password to my office.
Oh, but Master made Scrope swear never to tell anyone. Even Master himself.
How dare you question me? I've a mind to give you a matching set of ears.
Yes, sir. Of course, sir. Scrope begs forgiveness. It is the Black family motto, Master.
Right. Of course.
Master does remember it.
Of course I remember. It's the Black family reigns.
Is Master giving Scrope a test?
Well, certainly I remember. It's still stronger together, no?
Master has made Scrope laugh.
It's pure bloods forever, isn't it?
Close, Master. Scrope thinks Master is indeed testing Scrope. It is always pure?
Obviously.
And, of course, as Master knows, in French.
Ah, yes, of course. I order you to pronounce it for me.
Oh, but Master knows that Scrope's French is most pitiful. Very well. Toujours pur.
Ha! Thank you. Never speak of this conversation with me or anyone else.
Of course, sir. Scrope shall try his best to keep out of Master's way.
The polyjuice potion's wearing off. I best get out of sight. Made it just in time. It's wearing off.
Fig was right. I can't believe it worked. Now, to speak the password to the gargoyle.
Revelio. Alohomora.
Nice to see you, my young friend.
Revelio. 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 The gargoyle. That's where I need to speak the password. Revelio. Choose your pure. I wonder if all the elite wizarding families have a motto. Revelio. Alohomora. Revelio.
It's good to see you.
All thanks to Professor Fig's quick thinking. Now what?
Approach the pedestal in the antechamber and read the book that appears.
What can I expect to find in the book?
A story. I cannot say more. You may recognize some elements of it, as I was inspired by a tale with which many wizarding children are familiar.
I suspect there will be more to this than reading a book.
Your suspicions are correct. We shall speak when you are finished.
Has this been under the headmaster's nose all this time? Revelio. That must be the pedestal. Where am I? Professor Fitzgerald, can you hear me?
I am here. In this place, you may call me Neve. You shall be witness to a fable. Pay attention. Things are not always as they seem. You must move swiftly and cautiously. Use the tools you encounter to find me. The first... In this place, as in life, death takes many forms. Avoid each of them at all costs.
When I could, I'd be free by now.
They're gone. For now. I need to get out of here. Where could Neve be? I need to time this just right. I see. A staircase straight ahead. They won't be able to find me if I go up there. This is my chance. I'm coming, Neve. Too many. I must cross this road as fast as I can. That's where I need to go. But I need to find a way past them. Nothing this way, but more danger. There must be another way to find you. I need to turn back. There's no getting past them that way. That doorway looks like the only safe way forward. My chance. That's the way forward. Can this be? I think I'm invisible. See me at all. I can get closer to them. This is the way forward. Finally free. Now, where are you, Neve?
Run death thus far, but have yet to find me. Keep searching, but this time you will be unable to hide. Wield the wand you see before you. Do not squander its extraordinary power.
Revelio. This must be for me.
far from finished. Pass through the mourners ahead. Nothing is left.
I can't believe she's dead.
Oh, poor Niamh.
Niamh!
We won't be the same without her.
You found me, but you cannot undo what has been done. The magic of the stone can only conjure a shadow of my former self. But there is no light without shadow, as there is no shadow without light. Simply because you can eliminate darkness does not always mean that you should. Remember that as you witness my memory.
Isadora, what you did for your father was remarkable.
Wasn't it? And Percival needn't worry about the strands of emotion or the traces that this magic leaves. I found a way to contain all of it.
You haven't stopped.
Goblin silver.
You spoke to a goblin about this.
Don't worry, he has no idea what we're containing.
We don't know what effect any of this may have. The emotions, the dark traits.
You sound like Percival. And as it happens, I do know. It is a source of strength, of focus. Somehow it enhances my ability to wield magic.
I don't follow, Isadora.
I think we can harness it.
Power like this is not to be toyed with. In the wrong hands.
You saw what I did for my father. Oh, Niamh, imagine the good we could do. Everyone is in some kind of pain. Breathe it in. Oh, can you feel it?
Oh, Isadora. This must stop. All of us.
You've kept this power to yourselves for so long because you fear it. I choose to embrace it.
I'd seen Vakar's tower countless times. Never suspected.
Is it true? Has someone completed the first three trials?
It is, and I have.
But you are so
young. I know. You must be Professor Vakar.
I am.
Pleased to meet you. The pensive memory I just witnessed. Was Isadora inhaling painful emotions?
She was.
I found it disturbing. But how did she gain power from it? How did she harness it?
It was disturbing. Although, I wonder that you are asking about her power. I hesitate to reveal the location of my pensive to someone who, perhaps, has yet to understand the responsibility of power.
I can assure you, Professor, I do. In fact, what you don't yet know is that a dangerous goblin called Ranrock has accessed the repository at Rookwood Castle. He has learned to harness the contents of it as a source of immense power. He plans to use that power against wizard kind. We have no time to waste.
I see. Nonetheless, the knowledge you shall gain after you witness my memories is too valuable to share without further consideration. I shall require time to confer with the other keepers.
It seems we have no choice but to wait, frustrating as it is. I heard what you told Professor Bakar. Isadora was inhaling emotions to gain power?
She was, and she pulled emotions, as she did from her father, from Professor Fitzgerald, without permission.
Monstrous.
What's more, she said that she found a way to store the traces of magic she extracted in goblin silver.
The repositories?
Possibly. There's something I didn't get a chance to tell you earlier. Ranrock has been digging at locations tied to the five names he found in the journals of a goblin metal worker named Bragbor.
Five names? The Keepers, and who else? Isadora Morganac?
Precisely. That's how he's been one step ahead of us. Gringotts, the Tower, Rookwood Castle.
If the Keepers won't tell you where the next trial is yet, I say we at least maintain a watch on Ranrock. Perhaps he'll lead us to more information.
Perhaps. I hope to hear from Lodgok soon. I haven't heard anything since I learned of the drills. Oh, and as you've probably guessed by now, your Polyjuice plan worked like a charm.
I knew it would. I may have done too good a job distracting Black. I had no idea he can't hold his fire whiskey.
I shouldn't have reacted so bitterly about your goblin friend. I apologize. I hope we can finish what we started with the triptych. Please meet me at the southern coast. We can search for the final canvas piece.
Some exciting news to share.